ahead on NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman.
We'll take you behind the scenes of the Beef Culinary Center, and we'll get an up-close look at what the culinary team does on a day-to-day basis to help build beef demand.
And now, NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman with host Kevin Oxner.
Hello and welcome to NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman. I'm Kevin Oxner. Thanks for joining us. We're coming to you today from the Beef Culinary Center right here in Denver, Colorado. Located within the offices of the National Cattlemen's Beef Association, the team of professionals who work here each day help to keep beef and beef recipes front and center, especially with our consumers. Today, we'll spend some time learning more about what happens here and how it benefits beef producers like you and I. To begin, we turn to Cattleman to Cattleman reporter Brian Baxter for this report on the recently expanded Culinary Center.
Just a couple of years ago, an expansion doubled the size of the testing kitchens at the Denver office of the National Cattlemen's Beef Association. Now, the Beef Culinary Center features new equipment, expanding the opportunity to test and perfect a wide variety of beef recipes.
We recently went through and actually changed out one of our former executive boardrooms and opened it up, as you can see behind me, into our testing kitchen. So we've been able to expand what was three testing ranges into now four pods. So our testing development area can now go into full swing and test a lot more recipes in less time. What we look at is actually what is most popular in the consumer's household. So we're looking to test on all the recipes on those ranges so that we can minimize the amount of error that the consumer might have based on what range they're using, so that we can hopefully give them the best eating experience with beef.
Recipe testing and development ensures that all the beef recipes featured on beefitswhatsfordinner.com and in beef advertising are delicious and easy for consumers to make at home.
All our recipes are usually at least triple tested. We have two gas ranges, an electric flat top, and an electric coil range. So we try to cover all realms of ranges that consumers might have to hopefully help them be successful.
The Chekhov-funded Beef Culinary Team also develops recipes to provide valuable resources, such as the Confident Cooking with Beef pamphlet. It's full of information on choosing, storing, and preparing beef.
Confident Cooking with Beef is a really great tool, like to call it the Beef Bible. It has everything from how to shop for beef, how to store beef, and then every cooking method. So it really is a guide for the consumers to be able to have a successful beef eating experience. And so, you know, I think it's very important for us to continue to be able to test recipes and develop recipes. This facility is wonderful in the fact that we're able to take the time to be able to expand and test a recipe more than once. I really truly feel like we are a great support for and voice for beef. What we do is try to help and educate as much as possible and get beef on the tables.
Beyond the consumer focus, the commercial kitchen facilities at the Beef Culinary Center allow the professionals here to provide a wide variety of product development, recipe testing, and resources for food service companies interested in learning the latest about beef cuts and menu trends. I'm Brian Baxter reporting for NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman.
Here to tell us more about this center is Laura Hagen, the Senior Director of Culinary. Laura, thanks for coming to the show and inviting us into your kitchen.
Thank you. Welcome. Welcome.
You know, a lot of people who haven't been to NCBA headquarters may be surprised at the sheer expanse and scope of this kitchen. Tell us about the goal of the Culinary Center.
Yeah, well, the goal of the Culinary Center is really to showcase beef. I mean, that is the big thing that we do here. And that could be done through food production. It can be also done on our consumer side through recipe testing and putting those recipes out for consumers to use. So showcasing beef, really, really important that we showcase new cuts, new recipes, and really just new ways to work with beef to not only people who work here in the building, but outsiders and our guests that come inside.
As I look around, I see a lot of tools and technologies, some of which are very familiar and some of which I've never seen before. Tell us a little bit about those.
Yeah, well, I alluded a little bit to a consumer and a commercial side. So on this side, kind of over here, we have a kind of plethora of commercial appliances that are really available for anyone to use. Mm-hmm. So we like to think about maybe partnering with companies who might want to utilize some of these equipments to do some testing or anything with something that they might be wanting to do on a menu or something like that. The consumer side, of course, is our testing process. And so that is creating new recipes for consumers and solely for consumers and for retail customers who potentially want to use those recipes in their near the retail meat case.
And you mentioned that you do create and test recipes in here. And I've been fortunate enough to be one of those testers in some meetings that you've created some wonderful dishes. Tell us a little bit about that process.
Yeah, well, the process is pretty simple, but it's also very complicated. So it's kind of one of those things where we get a very easy concept, something that we want to create. We might get the directive to say, hey, let's create a bunch of really high protein recipes for breakfast. Okay. Something we're working on right now is actually some breakfast recipes because we want to make sure that people eat some beef for breakfast as well. Right. So the beef for breakfast recipes, those concepts come to us and then we kind of walk away and say, it'd be interesting if we did this. It'd be interesting if we did this and kind of find some ideas that we think maybe have some legs and we can actually move those forward. Mm-hmm. We then call in some of our testers. We have four testers on staff who are all chefs. They come in, do the testing, and then as a group, really the culinary department as well as our beef innovations group comes inside and they get to sample and give feedback. So if we think a option is viable, then we continue moving it forward through the testing process. We always test a recipe at least three times, so we call it our triple tested process. I can guarantee you that a lot of those will go even longer than that because we're very picky about the end result. But once that happens, we go into editing, we go and take a professional photograph of the recipe so that we can really sell it with that visual, and it goes on beefitswhatsfordinner.com so that they're available to consumers and states for outreach. Yep. And for doing them at home.
And you mentioned outreach and beefitswhatsfordinner.com. That's an important part of your mission, right? Because
yes.
It does absolutely no good to create great recipes if nobody knows where to go to find them.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's kind of why the process is so big for us, is that if a consumer does find our recipes, we want to make sure they're successful with them. Really difficult right now, sometimes people don't know what to purchase. So they walk into the meat case and they maybe pick a cut. And if they don't have guidance, it's really difficult. They might not have success. So what we are able to do is give them kind of that guide. Here, you've bought this cut, cook it this way, use these elements and these ingredients that will really help enhance it, and you've got a meal for your family and you'll be successful in your cooking experience. So,
give us your sense of your vision for the future of the Culinary Center. What do you see in the future?
Well, like I said, we've got a commercial and a consumer side. I'd really like to utilize both of them equally. We do a lot of food production on the commercial side, but I would like to bring some partners in to really start using some of this equipment and getting to know it better. We are able to give consumers a ton of educational information, but not as much on the food service side because we're not doing food service recipes on an ongoing basis. So utilizing this equipment and knowing what they have in the restaurants will help us provide them with inspiration and ideas beyond what we already do, and I think it would be fun just in general to forge those relationships. And I think on the consumer side, it's really educating consumers. So if we can get some people in here to do cooking education programs and that type of thing, I think that would be a lot of fun and have a big impact.
Well, whenever you need an extra tester, you give me a
you
call,
got it.
All right?
You got it, absolutely.
Thanks, Laura.
Thank you.
If you want to find out more about the Beef Culinary Center and the entire Beef Innovations Group, just visit the website beefinnovationsgroup.com. We're not done talking about the Culinary Center. Up next, we'll share some useful tips on how to properly thaw ground beef in a flash. Stay with us.
You're watching NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman on RFD TV.
Saddle up and make your way to Denver, Colorado for the 2017 Cattle Industry Summer Business Meeting. This is your chance to stay up to date on beef industry trends and policies, meet with industry leadership and your fellow cattlemen and women. Plus, you'll get insights on hot topics at the Issues Forums. Mark your calendar for the 2017 Cattle Industry Summer Business Meeting, July 12th to the 15th in Denver. Find out more at beefusa.org.
No matter what job I've got to do, my John Deere 5E tractor can do it all. Whether I'm cutting, moving feed, or building a fence. Using my 5E means my work gets done faster at a price I can afford, and that works for me.
Long live the courageous, the tenacious, the ones who push forward and give back. Long live the greater good, the helping hand, and long live the truck built to outlast them all. Ram, America's longest lasting pickups.
I cannot be in Washington, D.C. every day, and sometimes I can't be in Indianapolis to speak my voice with our legislators in the state. So NCBA does that for us, and it also makes sure that we have a voice in those instant emergency times, somebody that's watching our back.
Time-pressed consumers often find it difficult to plan ahead, and that limits their ability to include beef in their meals. Genoa French from the Beef Culinary Center joins us now to demonstrate a quick solution for thawing beef. Genoa, it always amazes me how many people don't know what they're going to eat 30 minutes before mealtime. And gosh, if you have a freezer full of frozen hamburger, that kind of limits including hamburger in the evening meal, doesn't it?
You're absolutely right. So we know the average consumer makes that dinner decision around 4:30. And we also know that ground beef is a great freezer staple. So it's something consumers buy when they're on sale and always keep it in the freezer. Mm-hmm. So we've done some work to make it so in 4 minutes or less, you can have recipe ready. So it's not going to be cooked. It's still going to be raw. You can put it in tacos. You can put it in meatballs and still follow your normal recipe that you want to include on your favorite family meal.
So that didn't have to sit in the refrigerator all day long while
you're at work. 24 hours. And we know that there's a couple different thawing methods. They talk about the refrigerator, they talk about cold water baths. So this is, and then they talk about the microwave. This is just instructions on how to use your microwave.
Okay.
So we don't have those brown corners and the pieces. We heard some consumers, they take them off and feed them to their dogs.
Right.
So you get the whole pound to use in whatever recipe you want to use at
home. Well, show us how to do it.
Yeah, so I'm going to show you two separate things real quick. We have, it's been developed for two different methods. We know that some consumers like to buy in large bulk packaging whenever it's on sale.
Sure.
You can do this, but what we're going to recommend is that you use a quart Ziploc bag and make sure you use a freezer one.
Yep.
And you can put about a pound and a quarter, depending on how big your family is, and you press it really flat. So you see how thin that profile is?
Yep.
This helps the thawing process, and it also helps stack real nicely in your freezer. So there's this option. We know the average consumer buys the 1 pound version of this and it goes directly into the freezer at home.
Gotcha.
So the method was designed to do either one.
Sure.
So you basically take your 1 pound package and
we've
it goes.
We've already cheated a little bit with this one.
Yeah, this one is has had the first minute, but we'll do 1 minute on there so we can keep talking. So this is the already packaged one. If you have, and I'm just going to do a quick minute button. So every consumer knows how to hit the minute. You don't have to change the power, nothing fancy. We're going to let this go. If you've frozen your tray over wrap, we need you to take it out of its paper and out of its plastic and out of some of the other things that are in there and put it in a 1 gallon Ziploc bag.
Oh.
So the big freezer Ziploc bags that you would have.
Right.
Put it in there and then put it on the plate in there.
Gotcha. But so not defrost, 1 minute,
Full power. A lot of the microwaves now have an easy minute button. Or just type in the 1 minute and that's all you have to do.
Okay.
So what we're going to do is we're going to let this run for a minute. And then we're going to take it out and you would flip it over and then hit the minute button again. And then the most important trick to this is that you let it rest for a minute before you do anything else on that. So and that kind of allows the heat to redistribute. Remembering we're not cooking in here. We're thawing. So we've got 9 seconds left. And the only kind of odd step that it'll say in there is it tells you to massage or to kind of break it up. So I'm going to show you that. Normally we would let this stop and let it sit in here for another minute.
For a minute.
Just kind of to calm down.
Then pull it out.
Yeah, but you're going to take it out.
Okay.
And you just want to break it up. And it'll be hard like this.
Sure.
And that's good. But what you do is after those minutes, you're going to take it out. And as you see, it's still frozen. So that would be that minute. And it'll come out just like thaw ground beef that you would have at home.
Then
and you
put it in the skillet and you're ready to roll.
You can put it in a skillet, you can put it in a bowl, add breadcrumbs, make meatloaf, whatever, meatballs, or whatever
Very
you want to do.
So I understand you have a handy reference guide teaching folks how to thaw hamburger.
There is. So if you go to beefitswhatsfordinner.com, there's a thawing tab. There's this information plus great ground beef recipes. You also can find the video on the Beef YouTube channel.
Well, it's something that's so easy, but so many consumers don't recognize that it's that easy to take something that, like you say, is a staple and have it ready in 4 or 5 minutes, ready for an evening meal.
Right.
Thanks for sharing that with us.
Thank you.
Of course, there's a lot more to know about beef in all of its forms. There are outstanding resources and recipes available on the website, beefitswhatsfordinner.com. Or you can always find video replays of our recipes on our website, cattlemantocattlemen.org. Don't go away. We'll be back right after this.
What does it mean to be dependable? It means you do what you say you'll do time and time again. Because performance isn't optional, and your task is essential. For over 95 years, we have proven ourselves to be the most dependable choice. That's why the cattlemen of this great nation trust Ritchie to provide fresh water on demand. Ritchie, proud to be a partner to the American cattlemen since 1921.
Want more profit out of your pasture? Then here's our 2 cents on using parasite control to make some dollars. In a trial of calves, Long Range outperformed Cydectin and Safeguard dewormers combined by as much as an extra 40 pounds. Yeah, that's a lot of extra profit. And that's why it pays to treat cattle with Long Range. Do not treat within 48 days of slaughter. Not for use in female dairy cattle 20 months of age or older, including dry dairy cows or in veal calves. Post-injection site damage can occur. These reactions have disappeared without treatment. You can't afford another season without Long Range.
Main reason that we belong to NCBA is because of the political action. As a producer, we don't have time to represent ourselves in Washington, D.C., so we rely on the NCBA to provide that service for us and take care of our lobbying for us. So there are too many issues in government that we don't have time to spend to take care of them ourselves.
Welcome back to Cattlemen to Cattlemen. I'm Kevin Ochsner. We've been showing you some of the ways the Culinary Innovation Team works to increase beef demand. This includes the development of new beef cuts from underutilized parts of the beef animal. The Flatiron Steak is an excellent example of one success that was developed as a result of Beef Checkoff funded research. Now, here's NCBA's Bridget Wasser with a demonstration of cutting techniques that can get additional value out of the chuck eye roll.
Now, what I'm gonna do is show you how to make 3 innovative beef cuts from the chuck eye roll. I'm gonna again start on the back end or the rib end of this chuck eye roll to create my first new steak option. Again, we have the same muscles present in the back end of this chuck roll that we do in the front end of the rib roll. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut 3 1-inch chuck eye, or they're sometimes also called Delmonico steaks, from the back end of this chuck eye roll. The reason that I can only cut 3 is that the muscles that are present in this back end of the chuck eye roll are just getting their start here anatomically. They are gonna continue into the ribeye roll and get bigger as they go back and towards the back of the animal. And so I've only got about 3 inches of those muscles to work with. Kind of corresponds to where you see this natural tapering in the chuck eye roll. So I can cut 3 1-inch thick steaks, and then I'm gonna run out of room and have to cut a new different beef item. So I'll cut 3 1-inch steaks. Go ahead and put these on a platter. And these we call chuck eye steaks. As I mentioned, they also can be called Delmonico steaks or new Delmonico steaks, particularly if they're being used for food service. They're great center of the plate items, look a lot like a ribeye steak, perform a lot like a ribeye steak, and they can be grilled or cooked with dry heat cookery. And we get 3 of those per chuck eye roll. Okay, those are the chuck eye steaks or Delmonico steaks. Now, we can only cut 3 of those because we needed those key muscles to be present in those cuts. So the question becomes, well, what do we do with the rest of this chuck eye roll, the rest of this piece? How do we add value to that? One way that we can do that is by cutting the next 2 cuts that I want to show you. The next item we can cut from any portion of this chuck eye roll, We call these boneless country style ribs, and they're very simple to generate. All we do is continue cutting 1-inch thick steaks or portions, and then I lay those on the table, and then I just simply split them in half lengthwise. Doing that generates 2 boneless country style ribs. I'll continue demonstrating that. Cut a 1-inch thick steak or portion from the chuck eye roll after you've cut your chuck eye steaks. Lay that 1-inch portion on the table and split it in half lengthwise. From each 1-inch portion, we get 2 boneless country style ribs. And I can continue cutting those really the entire length of this chuck eye roll. A 1-inch thick portion, split in half lengthwise. And these are our boneless country style ribs. They're a great new item, a great innovative way to use what's left of this chuck eye roll once your chuck eye steaks are removed. And these items are a great center of the plate item. They perform very well, but they do need to be braised or cooked in shallow liquid. And then you can apply different flavors to them and even finish those on the grill, but they do need to be braised first. So those are the boneless country style ribs. Now from the other portion or the remaining portion of this chuck eye roll, you also have the option of cutting a roast. We call it a chuck eye roast or even America's beef roast. And you can cut it from any portion that's desired of this whole chuck eye roll, and then you can portion it to any size that's desired. If you're trying to hit a particular weight, target weight, you can certainly portion those to the size that's desired. There's an example of a great little chuck eye roast or America's beef roast. You can make it larger or smaller as needed. You can also actually tie or net these and make them a really nice round shape, and then you could carve slices off of these. So they're pretty versatile, and they do work well with a dry rub and then right into the oven. So a good application for this America's beef roast.
Well, that's a look at how new cuts are developed here in the Culinary Center. The next step is coming up with a wonderful beef recipe. And joining us now is Chris Geigel with the beef culinary team. Chris, you've piqued my interest with beer, beef, cheese, and apples here. Tell me what you got going.
So this is one of the newer recipes we developed here. It's called our beef and kale queso fondido. It's basically a beer and cheese dip with a beefy twist.
Outstanding.
So I'll show you how to make that here. Okay. First, I'm going to turn on my frying pan.
Sure.
So you start with a little beer, and who doesn't love that?
Okay.
We're using a craft beer here in Colorado. Beer's really big, so yeah. I picked a local craft beer, but you can use your favorite beer. So that's going to go into the frying pan.
All right. Yeah, there's lots of places you can find that here.
And then diced tomatoes with some diced chilies in it. I use a mild, but if you like it spicy, you can use the hot version.
Okay.
So that's going to go in here too.
Like a can of that?
One can of that.
Sure.
I'm going to stir that up a little bit.
Okay. And are we trying to boil that, or how hot are we bringing that?
We're trying to bring it to a boil. So while that's working and heating up, I'm going to have my bowl of cheese here. It's 2 cups of shredded Mexican blend cheese.
Sure.
You can use a low-fat version if you're looking to be a little healthier, but this is full-fat here because we love our flavor.
That's right.
I'm going to add a little cornstarch to that
toss
that around. It helps keep the cheese separate. It also helps to thicken up your fondito.
Oh, I'll be darned. Okay.
So I'm going to toss that around. So this isn't quite hot yet, so I'm going to set that aside.
Okay.
Also going into this is any leftover ground beef or beef that you have. So you can use pot roast.
Yep.
You can use ground beef. We have some steaks here that were left over from our dinner the other night. So you can take one of those and cut it up here.
Cut it up in small slices.
Little small pieces.
And you're going to put that in before the cheese typically?
We're going to put it in at the end, but since that's not hot yet, we're just going to chop it up now.
That's great. So just any, I mean, you're telling us that any beef item that you have in your refrigerator, I mean, you're not picky, it's just kind of...
Not picky.
Yeah.
So good. Any beef item you have left over, you can use.
Yeah.
So this is starting to boil here, as you can see.
Sure.
Once it comes to a boil, we're going to add our cheese a little bit at a time.
All right.
So about half a cup at a time.
All right.
Add that, stir it in.
Let that melt, huh?
We want to let it melt. We don't want to add too much at one time and have a clump up on it.
Right. And how much cornstarch did you say you normally put in there?
It's a tablespoon to the 2 cups of cheese that we put in there.
No doubt.
Add a little more cheese now that that's melted.
Yeah. Thicken it up pretty good, huh?
Yeah, the cornstarch helps that, and you can see the cheese is starting to melt and get all stringy here.
So this is a recipe you all actually created here in the kitchen.
It is.
Yeah.
It was a trial of love.
Is that right?
A lot of iterations to get it to a point that was easy and turned out really well. But, you know, that's kind of what we do here. All of our recipes are at least triple tested. So
that's neat.
Going to add the rest of that cheese in there.
Yeah, that's looking good now.
getting nice and thick.
Oh yeah.
And so once all the cheese melts and starts to bubble a little bit, we're gonna add whichever beef we choose. Okay. I'm gonna use the steak since just chop
if
that
you
up.
Got steak, let's use steak. That's my attitude.
So I'm just gonna pour this in here.
Okay.
And also, we're gonna add a little bit of chopped kale to this. It helps to add a really nice color, and it's also really good for you, so.
Well, tell me more about it. I mean, I hear about kale a lot. It's in lots of nutrition magazines.
Sure.
Why is that becoming so popular, Chris?
Kale's really popular because green leafy vegetables in general are super high in most nutrients that you need. So it just became the really big food right now because it's really good for you, and you can do a, it's very versatile.
Yeah.
So I'm not gonna add all of this in, just a little bit here.
Gotcha.
I'm gonna just turn down my heat a little bit.
Sure.
Stir that in.
Look at that. Boy, that's quick too.
That's quick, and that's done. You just wanna make sure that you bring your beef up to temperature. So you, once it's kind of together and you add your steak, you wanna cook it for about 3 to 5 minutes to make sure your leftover beef comes to at least 165 degrees.
Okay, gotcha. That does look nice with that, yeah.
A little color, see the beef in there?
Sure.
So I'm just gonna put some in the serving bowl here.
Sure. Look at that.
And there you have it. And you can serve it with your favorite things. If you want to be a little healthier, you can do carrots, celery, and apples. If you want to be a little more traditional, there's some pita and tortilla chips here.
Outstanding. And again, if people are looking this up on their website, they're looking for what?
The beef and kale queso fundido.
Very good. Thank you so much for all your good work and for bringing us this great recipe.
Our pleasure.
For this and other outstanding beef recipes, visit the website beefitswhatsfordinner.com. Or you can always find video replays in the recipe section of our website, cattlemantocattlemen.org. Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Forward. It's more than a direction. It's mandatory. Because the beef business rewards the progressive, the doers, the ones who know what it takes to go easy on cattle and never set them back. So set your eyes on the horizon. Turn your back to the wind and move your herd the only way you know. Forward. Vista Vaccines. Always ahead.
There are many great reasons to join NCBA, and that includes exclusive NCBA member discounts and benefits from some outstanding companies.
Hi, this is Kerry Bastine, president of Roper Apparel and Footwear, Stetson Apparel Boots, and Tin Hall. We are very proud sponsors of the NCBA, and for all new members signing up with the NCBA, you get 50% off your first purchase, and for all Go Forward members, you get 25% off 4 times a year. Go to urbanwesternwear.com, click on the NCBA specials, use your coupon code for your first 50% off, and come back to Urban Westernwear all year long and use your 25% coupons that you'll find in the National Cattleman's newspaper.
Big discounts on boots, clothing, and Western apparel is just one of the many amazing deals you get as an NCBA member. Don't miss out. Join NCBA today and enjoy these exclusive member discounts. Find out more at beefusa.org.
Welcome back. We've been learning today about the work of the professionals here in the Beef Culinary Center. One of the valuable results of the work done here is the recipe outreach and education that appears on the Beef It's What's For Dinner website and the YouTube page. We learned more about that as Sharon Allseth reports.
A valuable resource for consumers is the Beef It's What's For Dinner website. The website offers more than just recipes. It also features advice on how to purchase beef, cooking tips, and facts about nutrition. Whether looking for information or inspiration, the website has become a key point of contact with consumers who want to learn more about beef.
We know that consumers are coming to beefitswhatsfordinner.com as their go-to resource for beef.
So this was really a great opportunity for us to get a lot of information out in a short amount of time to a very, very wide audience. And our mission was is to really show consumers how easy it is to cook beef and make healthy, nutritious meals for your family.
The Beef It's What's For Dinner brand has now also been extended to other online resources. There's a Facebook page, there's a Twitter feed, and consumers can view dozens of how-to videos on the Beef It's What's for Dinner YouTube page.
This is where we can turn them on to all the tips that we have in cooking and all the great recipe information and continue to link them back to beefitswhatsfordinner.com and with these how-to videos.
I travel all over the country speaking in front of consumer groups, chef groups, and they're really, really wanting this kind of information. We've gotten great reaction. You know, a lot of bloggers have picked up and used our information, which is really a cost-effective way to get the beef message out there.
Right, not all consumers are looking through recipe books anymore. Some are going online, using social media to access beef nutrition information. I know for me, I want it on demand, and I can use social media as a way to get great cooking information. So in this case, this project really puts beef right out there with the social media and the website and connects them to that consumer right when they're ready to cook our product.
The work done at the Beef Culinary Center is the starting point, but with the reach of the World Wide Web, the work done here can now extend to consumers in every corner of the world, enabling them to choose beef more easily and more often. From the Beef Culinary Center, I'm Sharon Allseth, reporting for NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman.
It's a fast-paced world these days for everyone, especially for families. And making meals fast and portable is sometimes required. Pam Nash, one of the recipe testers with the Beef Culinary Center, joins us now with just the thing for busy lifestyles. Pam, looks like you're going to build something that is a family favorite of ours when we go to livestock shows, and that's on-the-go beef tacos. Is that right?
That's right. This recipe is a lot of fun. It's quick and easy. It's easy to customize to anybody's taste, and they're just super fun. You can do them at barbecues. You can do them at birthday parties. They're really quick and easy to do.
Well, let's get started.
Okay, so we started, actually, we took a pound of ground beef, and I used my favorite taco seasoning mix and 3/4 cup of water, put it in a pan, cooked it all up. You cook your beef to 160 for food safety, and mix it all together, and you get your beef mixture.
Sure.
Once you get your beef mixture, take your favorite chip. Today we have nacho cheese chips.
Sure.
And then you can fill it with beef and then fill it with all of your favorite toppings.
And again, no dishes to deal with when we're done.
No dishes, easy to do.
Very good.
First, we'll go ahead and put in a couple spoonfuls or forkfuls here.
You bet. Or half a bowl,
or half a bowl, whatever you want to do of your beef.
I know my wife normally, we cook this in advance, and then she has it in the refrigerator or cooler, and then we just put it in a crock pot to warm it up in time for lunch meal.
For lunch, absolutely, absolutely. So once you get your beef in there, you can top it with your toppings. Today here, we have tomatoes.
Yeah.
I have shredded cheddar cheese. I have avocados, diced avocados. I have some chopped up cilantro.
Oh, yeah.
I have shredded lettuce. I have salsa, of course.
You bet.
And I have some green onions.
Delicious.
And if I was making this for me to eat after my beef, I'm going to start with diced tomatoes.
Okay, perfect.
And just throw those in.
Oh, sure. Take all the tomatoes.
All
right, what else?
And then I'm going to put in my shredded cheddar cheese because I love cheese.
Yeah.
Oh, I really love cheese.
Yeah, you do love cheese.
And then I'm going to finish off with avocado.
Well, you just will take all the avocados as well. That's delicious.
And then that's your serving bowl as well. That's how you eat it.
Now, speaking of serving bowl, it looks like you did a couple of variations that you could actually eat at home, but these look a little different. Can you tell us more about these?
Absolutely. We did 5 different variations on this. This first one we have is our chili cheese taco, and we used a corn chip, and instead of the taco seasoning, we used chili seasoning in the beef. The second one we have here is our Mediterranean. Instead of the taco seasoning, we use 2 teaspoons of Greek seasoning, and then we use a multigrain chip.
Oh, wow.
The third one we have is our ranch. We take out the taco seasoning, we use a ranch packet.
Perfect.
Into the beef, and we use a ranch chip. The fourth one we have is the meat and potatoes taco.
Oh.
So we take out the taco seasoning, we use a gravy mix in the beef, and then we serve it over your favorite potato chips. And the last one, one of my favorites, is the cheeseburger taco. So we take out the taco seasoning, we actually add ketchup and mustard into the beef, and then we serve it over our favorite cheese puff.
That is delicious and so easy, and as you say, so much fun.
Yeah.
Thanks so much for bringing us this great recipe with beef.
Thank you.
For on-the-go beef tacos and other great beef recipes, visit the website beefitswhatsfordinner.com. Or you can always find them on our website at cattlemantocattlemen.org. Stay with us. We'll be right back after this.
Do you know all you need to about working cattle? Did you know there are proven methods that can reduce stress for the animals, for you, and for your crew? Learn from the experts who can help sharpen your stockmanship and stewardship skills. By attending a stockmanship and stewardship event, you'll learn proven ways to work cattle more efficiently, skills that can help put more money in your pocket. Find out more and locate a training session near you at the website stockmanshipandstewardship.org.
Well, I think a rancher has to be a steward of the land. There's nobody else that can take care of land better than a rancher. When we switched over to the Purina products, it was a step in the right direction.
The difference we see in the cattle is the consistency of their nutrition.
The cattle hold their condition a lot better throughout the whole year.
It does make a difference that we can see, day in and day out.
There are many great reasons to join NCBA, and that includes exclusive NCBA member-only discounts, such as savings up to $2,500 on new equipment purchases from John Deere.
We at John Deere are proud to be sponsors of the NCBA. We've been long-term sponsors and have been in the livestock business for over 125 years. John Deere has a wide variety of products that support you in the industry. We have a wide variety of discounts that are exclusive to you as NCBA members. You can visit our John Deere dealers locally throughout the United States to be able to find those specific discounts and the products that would apply to your needs. So thank you for being an NCBA member and allowing us to support you.
Saving big money on equipment purchases from John Deere is just one of the great deals you get as an NCBA member. Don't miss out. Join NCBA today at beefusa.org.
Being part of the NCBA gives you a voice in the cattle industry, not only locally, nationwide, and in Capitol Hill. And if you don't have that voice, if we're able to raise our concerns through the NCBA process, then it's difficult to get things done. NCBA helps us do that.
Welcome back. Cattle producers are always on the lookout for allies outside the industry who can share with consumers the health benefits of beef. Brad Bulla has more on an important Beef Checkoff funded event aimed at reaching nutritionists and other health influencers to help share the positive story of beef.
At first glance, it may look like just another meeting, but this is Live Well 2016. An event funded by the Beef Checkoff and attended by an elite group of health professionals and nutrition communicators. The Live Well participants heard from leading experts on topics ranging from the value of beef in the diet to understanding beef cuts and how cattle are raised.
One thing that I learned about beef this week that was really surprising to me was the different cuts of meat and how you can use them in a lot of different culinary applications. And I think that consumers need to hear a little bit more about those lean options and the ways that they can prepare them in their homes.
Whether in the kitchen, at a restaurant, or during a presentation, the event gave participants focused time to engage in discussions about beef nutrition, food preparation, and beef production.
As I look back over my career the last 20 years, I think, and you consider the retail meat case and how it's changed over the last, say, two decades, the consumer is ever more confused by all the variety of offerings in the retail meat case. And so anytime we get the opportunity as faculty from the Institute or as advocates for the industry to share the production side of the industry with groups like this group of bloggers and registered dietitians, we feel like that's time and effort well spent.
I believe it's important for dietitians to be able to share this message that we've learned at Live Well about how farmers and ranchers really do care for their animals. So it's important for us to really expand what the real knowledge and science is behind beef and around protein and the needs that Americans have, and better help them apply that to their daily practice.
I'm Brad Buller reporting for NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen.
Joining us now is Shelley Johnson. She's in charge of nutrition outreach for NCBA. Shelley, we just saw some great coverage from the Live Well event, and I'm curious, who are the people who attend, and more importantly, why is it important that we reach out to those folks?
So we brought together a mixture of registered dietitians, mainly media dietitians, supermarket dietitians, and food and parenting bloggers. This is a really important mix of communicators because these are the folks that consumers trust. They also have a broad reach, so we consider them message multipliers, meaning when we give them beef nutrition information that inspires them or is consistent with the kind of information they share, they share it out. And it's really well received because they are a trusted resource for consumers.
And what kind of tangible results have you seen from this recent Live Well event?
So that's my favorite thing. When I get back to my office after going to one of these events is watching to see how they use the information that was shared. We bring them together at the end of every Live Well event to ask them, like, what was the most powerful thing you learned, or how do you think you'll share this information? And the kind of collaboration that comes out of that is really exciting for me to see as a program manager. I think one of the most powerful ahas I had was when we shared information about beef as a first food for babies. That's actually Chekhov-funded research. We shared it with them. And a retail dietitian that attended the event, she went back to her corporate retail dietitian team and said, we got to do something with this. And they're going to be launching a campaign in store. And this is for a large regional retailer that's going to be doing this later this summer. So I'm pretty stoked to see how that shapes up.
That's outstanding. Now tell me this. I know this event is important, but you do a lot of other things to reach out to nutritionists and let them know the health and nutrition benefits of beef. Tell us more about that.
Sure. So we reach dietitians on a regular basis. We know they're really important. But we also know that physicians are really important too. They don't have a lot of time to spend talking about food or nutrition with their patients, but we know they're answering questions, and we know they're sharing information about diet. We know that cardiologists are typically telling people how to shape their diet to improve heart health, and sometimes beef comes into that conversation. And we also realize that the amount of training that medical doctors get on nutrition is pretty limited in their training. So we're looking at one-on-one ways or broader ways to reach this group. I have a really great story to tell about a doctor that we engaged with last year. We shared with him the bold research that I know you and I have talked about before.
Yes.
And he was really wowed by it. Like, he didn't realize beef's role in heart healthy eating pattern. And he wrote a story in U.S. News and World Report.
Wow.
Yeah, so we were really excited to see that. The Chekhov also sponsors key conferences that medical doctors attend. So we're looking for creative ways to clear the clutter and really inspire them to share the information that they see firsthand at those conferences. And then, of course, we're creating continuing medical education experiences for them, like webinars or videos, so we can make that kind of education available at their time.
It's certainly important to influence the influencers. And I'm curious, are you sensing more interest in beef nutrition?
I say all the time, there's no more exciting time to be in food and nutrition communications than right now. If you're on social media, there's not a day that goes by that you don't see someone share a picture of a smoothie or a dinner they made for their family or a meal they ate at a restaurant. So people are talking about it amongst themselves, and they're looking to experts to help, you know, find out what's the truth about what I'm eating, the truth about where my food comes from, or the science behind a diet or a health tip I should be following. So it's really exciting, but not only is the trend piece of it informing how we shape our programs, we also use consumer research, so market research. And when we survey consumers and ask them, what are the reasons that you'll limit your beef consumption? Five of the top six reasons are health and nutrition reasons. So it is definitely an important piece of what the Chekhov's doing.
Yeah. So speaking of the Chekhov, as we think about other beef producers like myself that pay into this Chekhov, what would you tell us about the kind of returns that this work provides for those of us beef producers?
So I speak from experience when I say that the Live Well program is not new. We do one of these big splashy events every few years because we can ride the wave of the benefits for years to come. It never ceases to amaze me that I'll see a quote in a media story from a dietitian that attended a Live Well either recently or in years past, something that still motivates her to talk about beef favorably. So I know that we're picking the right kind of information to share with them.
Sure.
It also positions both NCBA staff and the Chekhov as a really trusted resource with this really powerful audience. The dividends pay off for years and years to come, and we're excited to build on it, and we create programs that help shape what they learned at the Live Well event into things that we know that they really want to share out with consumers even more.
Fantastic. As we build this cow herd, there's nothing more important than building demand and letting people know that they can eat a delicious product and do it without having any health concerns.
You're
Thank
so
you
so right,
much.
Kevin. Yep.
Don't go away. We'll be right back.
Stay Tough Fence will last three times longer and is four times stronger than low tensile fencing. High tensile wire, solid vertical stays, and tight fixed knots all provide superior strength. You will use fewer posts, saving time, labor, and money. Protect your investment for generations with Stay Tough Fence. Stay strong. Stay tight. Stay tough.
If your group or association is planning a meeting and are on a thrifty budget, check out Virtual Video Baxter. That's me. I'll video a personalized welcome, then furnish several humorous stories to run between your speakers. Sign books can be used as auction items. We've done rodeos, museums, bowl sales, the conservation service. Use your imagination. Give us a call, 800-654-2550 at BaxterBlack.com.
Did you know that Prefort makes over 1,000 different farm, ranch, and rodeo items? And now, thanks to Prefort Direct, it's easier than ever before to get access to every item Prefort makes delivered direct to your local dealer. For more information about Prefort Direct, visit us at Prefort.com. Prefort, America's number one name in farm, ranch, and rodeo.
It's not uncommon for cattle farmers to keep livestock ponds stocked with fish. Penny and her husband often take their guests out to their pond, but they're more sophisticated fishermen than most. They have outgrown the crude clunking lures, the simulated plastic worms, the oh-so-amateur refrigerated night crawlers. They are fly fishermen. Their friend John is a fly fishing aficionado and a frequent guest. One afternoon, Penny walked with him across the pasture to the pond. John, the minimalist, went up the bank carrying all his tackle in his shirt pocket. Penny, the princess of preparedness, set her backpack on the 10-foot dirt edge of the half-full pond. She lay out everything she would need neatly along the bank and began casting and laying out the line and reeling and ebbing and flowing, all in perfect rhythm to the lapping of the wavelets on the shore. She realized she was not alone. She looked around to see 40 curious Angus heifers looking over her fly fishing inventory like single mothers at a yard sale. Penny tried shooing them back, but it was like trying to shoo snow off the porch. They had her surrounded. John! John! She kept calling, trying to get some help. She was actually whacking heifers on the head with her bare hand whilst holding the rod above the milling crowd. One of the heifers stuck her head under the fishing line. It startled her, the heifer, I mean. She began backing up, and the line hooked on a round ear tag button on the back side. The crowd parted as Penny played the heifer like an 800-pound walleye. "Keep your tip up," encouraged John. The heifer dived and ducked. She breached and sounded. She wiggled and shook until finally she broke free. "Wow," said John to the panting Penny. "That's sure the big one that got away." "Yep," said Penny, "but we mostly just catch and release." This is Baxter Black from out there.
Thanks, Baxter. We appreciate you sharing your wit and wisdom with us each and every week. Now, if you'd like to learn more about what's happening with NCBA's Cattleman to Cattleman, you can find us on Facebook. Be sure to like our page, and we'll keep you updated with photos, details on upcoming shows, and much, much more. And it's a great way to connect with other cattlemen and women across the country. So check us out on Facebook. Don't go away. We'll have more right after this.
There are many great reasons to join NCBA, and that includes exclusive NCBA member-only discounts, such as savings on new equipment purchases from New Holland.
Hi, I'm Mike Corman with New Holland Agriculture, and I'm pleased here to talk about our New Holland member benefits to the National Cattlemen's and Beef Association members. New Holland offers special benefits to NCBA members where they can save up to $1,000 off the purchase of a New Holland equipment. Members can save off the purchase of New Holland hay and forage and mid-range tractors, as well as other products. We have New Holland dealers located throughout the United States. Stop into your New Holland dealer and learn more. New Holland and NCBA, smart partners for agriculture.
Savings on equipment purchases from New Holland is just one of the fantastic deals you get as an NCBA member. Don't miss out. Join NCBA today at beefusa.org.
It's time now for this week's legacy photos submitted by ranching families from around the country. Let's have a look. Now don't forget, you can send us your pictures of your farm or ranch by visiting our website, cattlemantocattlemen.org. Be sure to include your ranch or farm name and your hometown, and we may use them on a future episode. Well, that's our time for this week's special edition of NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen. Thanks to our friends here in the Beef Culinary Center for hosting us and for the great work they do every day. And thank you for watching NCBA's Cattlemen to Cattlemen. We'll see you again next week, right here on RFD TV.